If you're building your own Vibe Code app and you really don't know where to start, you don't know where your backend database should be, you don't know what frontend to use, I mean, all of this can be solved now with Zite's new database component. Yes, it used to be that if you built something with Zite, you had to connect it to a backend like Google Sheets or Airtable. But now, thanks to Zite's brand new database feature, you can have the data living right in Zite itself. We're gonna be breaking this down in the video, so if this is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission here to help you unlock the full potential of your no-code tools. And one of the tools that we've been following along for years now is Fillout. We absolutely love their forms and we are very excited as a company that they launched Zite as a new product. Zite is kind of an add-on to Fillout. Fillout, one of the most advanced form softwares out there, but now Zite allows us to build our own Vibe Code/no-code apps. If you're not really well-versed about what Vibe Coding is, it's basically talking to an AI prompt to build your own application. So imagine not needing to code at all, not even needing to really know how everything interconnects, at least not to get started. And so that's what we're going to be breaking down in this video, is setting up your own Zite Vibe Code, but specifically focused on the data layer that is now available in Zite. Now, before we get to the heart of the video, I first want to invite you to join me for some free training. Now, of course, we're not going to be talking about Airtable in this particular video, but it's a tool that we use a lot for most of our projects. And our free Airtable crash course is available to you if you sign up at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course. I'll include links wherever you found this video, and you can get that training sent to you so that you learn all the key features of Airtable. But without further ado, let's go ahead and hop on into my screen. We are starting in Fillout. I'm at fillout.com. I'm inside of my workspace for Gap Consulting, and I've got the examples folder or workspace here. This is where we build a lot of our examples for our YouTube channel. As you can see, it's currently empty, and we are going to create a new Zite. Zite, as I mentioned, is an add-on for Fillout, and we have a prompt in here that we are going to start with. Now, I really like to work with other AI in tandem with my Vibe Code builds. So I'll go into ChatGPT, I'll go a couple of rounds and ask ChatGPT to give me a prompt, which I'll then copy and paste into Zite. This I found really just makes it a lot easier. The back and forth with ChatGPT seems to be a little bit easier, and I'm not relying on Zite and burning through credits on Zite. Now, of course, you don't have to do it this way, but I find it's really easy to get up and running. And my prompts, frankly, they're a lot better when I copy them from ChatGPT because it kind of summarizes what I'm trying to get at. So here we are building a simple CRM for freelancers with four tables. We have clients, we have projects, we have tasks, and we have invoices. So we're gonna go ahead and put these all together in our Zite app, and you can see how quickly this comes together. But here's where we're gonna get into Zite's database. Previously, as I mentioned, we might connect this to Google Sheets, to Airtable, but now Zite has its own internal database. And all I have to do is select it here when I'm building my Vibe Code app. And it's gonna say, well, do you have an existing database? So we could have started building this database manually ourselves on the back end, but I don't want to do that. I'm just going to create a new database. Now, bear in mind, this is in beta, so, you know, be a little bit flexible with it. But you can see I've now said, hey, we're going to create a new database in Zite to support this app that I've outlined. And that's it. Let's go ahead and send this prompt in. Now, Zite's going to be thinking for a little bit on the back end. This could take a few minutes, so we're going to go ahead and pause here and pick this back up when Zite is done with its processing. So the prompt started, and I did something that I seem to do a lot whenever I'm building in Zite. I don't know why I don't always properly connect these things, but as it started processing, it said, hey, we're waiting for your input. We don't have a database synced yet. And this happens to me occasionally when I'm building in Zite. I think I've connected it to my database or told it where the database is, and I make a mistake. So let's connect again. I thought I went through these steps, but it wasn't sufficient at the time. So we're gonna be saying, hey, we're analyzing this app. You can see that it's designing the database. This is all getting built, again, in real time. And once the tables and the database itself are built, then hopefully Zite can move forward with the app. So I'm going to try to pause again, and we'll come back. It actually wasn't any time at all. The database has been created and we can see the tables listed out here. So it's actually not created yet. In fact, this is what the recommendations for the tables are. So you can see that we're getting some input from Zite in terms of, you know, what it thinks we should build. And it's telling us these are the names of the different fields that we're going to create in the different tables and the type of data that we expect to live in that table. So we'll have a client name, for example, it's going to be a text field. We'll have a company name, text field, email field, email field. You get the idea. So we're going to go ahead and go with their recommendations. I'm not doing anything crazy or fancy here, but do note that we could add additional tables if Zite in the prompt didn't pull out exactly what we wanted. We could add new stuff here, but I'm going to roll with what they set up. This is exactly what we asked for, in fact, in our prompt. So no surprise here. We'll say create database and we'll come back once it's done processing. All right, our database and the front-end application are now complete, at least the first pass. And in total, it took Zite about 8.5 to 9 minutes to get this all set up. Now, what we really want to focus on here, of course, is that back-end database. But really quickly, I do want to walk through the app. So we have our clients here. We have an add client, which pops up a modal or a form where we can enter in the client information. We also can switch over to projects. Let's take a look at projects. We don't have any yet. We can add new projects. Looks like we have to create clients first before we can add projects. Now we've got our tasks over here. Probably no tasks either because we haven't actually put any information in the database. Looks like there might be a little bit of a rendering issue here. We're not actually able to load any tasks. Of course, I think there are probably none. And then we have our invoices. And my guess is, oh, okay, we actually get something to load here. And it looks like a pretty good, you know, high level dashboard in terms of the total amount of invoices, what's overdue, etc. And we can add invoices here. We probably need to have projects. Yeah, we have to have a project before we can invoice against it. But that's our front end, like a pretty lightweight freelancer CRM, which, I mean, hey, it's got a lot of information, a lot of flexibility. But what we care about for this video in particular is that back end. This database has been built all through the prompt, the same prompt as you saw. And this is going to look very similar to, let's say, an Airtable database. We're going to have similar field types. So our tables are going to be up here at the top. And then each table or set of data is going to have different elements that we can represent within that. So let's take a look at our clients table first. Again, all built through the prompt with the AI. So we've got our clients. We're asking for the client name, company, email, phone, notes, projects, and then we can add additional columns, or, you know, what we would say in other databases would be fields. So we can add this, and you can see that we get a pretty typical list of different elements here. So this has to do with the type of data we're storing in a column. So here we've got text, long, rich text, numbers, percent, currency, and checkbox or Boolean. We've got a link capability, so we can link to other things. So we could link our clients to projects, for example, and it looks like that's already happened here. Let's take a look at this. So we see if we were to edit this field, yes, we've got projects. We allow multiple projects or not, and it would stand to reason that our projects are also linked to clients. Let's click over to our projects to confirm that here. So over here, yep, we see our linked client. So let's just put some sample data in. I'll add myself as a new client here in the database. And let's say Cap Consulting. And you know, you get the idea. I could fill out all this information. Let's add a project. So I'll say the Gap project. Let's go ahead and give it a name here. And can I link it to the client here? Sure enough. Link that. I'll just check the box. All right, works a little bit differently than I expected, but still pretty self-explanatory. And I should be able to come back here. Interestingly, I'm not seeing this automatically linked to projects. I wonder if I need to give it a refresh on my database to see that it's reflected here. I did. So once I refreshed, I see that the project that I linked to the client, when I go over to the clients, then I see the client is also linked to the project. So pretty straightforward stuff here. I think one of the very cool things with using the Zite database is that there's not really much of a limitation to the amount of records that we can store. It's kind of wild to say that because one of the biggest limitations to no-code tools has always been how much data we can actually store in these cloud-based databases. And Zite is basically saying, No real limitations. You can have as much data as you want. And if you think about the actual cost of running Zite, I mean, I'm on an upgraded plan. I pay whatever I pay for fill out, but then my Zite is an extra $40 a month. And the fact that an unlimited number of users can now access any apps that I've built in Zite, that's game changing. In terms of savings, in terms of what I'm getting, the value that I'm getting for using this tool, it's almost incomparable to what's on the market right now in the best way possible. The value for Zite is incalculable. It's so good. So here we can see, though, the different data layers. And again, all of this was built automatically for me. Let's actually pop back into the app. I want to see, oh, look at that. I mean, I've got the client now showing up here properly. If I go into projects, hopefully it will load. I don't have a stage for this project, which is probably why it's not in showing up here, because I've got planning, progress, or completed. I must need to go back to my database and probably update the status here. There we go. That makes sense. Now we should see that reflected here. I might need to refresh again to give the app a moment to render that new project. Let's go ahead and flip back into projects, and sure enough, it's showing up here. So we can see it in the planning stage. And again, ultimately we would tie tasks to this. We would tie invoices to the project over time. But this whole thing was stood up for me with a simple prompt, and I don't need to integrate a third-party database tool. So, couple of high-level thoughts on this. Number one, massive value that I've already spoken to. In terms of what you're getting for your spend with Zite, I'm spending an extra $40. The Zite cost only comes into effect, by the way. What you spend with Zite is what you're allowed to do when you're building new applications. So if you're not doing a lot of consistent building, if you just build your app once and then run it, in theory, you don't need a very high Zite plan, because what Zite is charging you for is the AI prompts and the code that's being written on the back end. If you're not doing that, you can have a relatively low Zite plan and not pay a lot and still get a lot of functionality from this. It has nothing to do with how many users can access your apps. It just has to do with how many prompts you get every month to write and update your apps. So massive, massive value coming from Zite in that. Now, the other key takeaway here is that the database only currently can link to one. So an app can only connect to one database. If you wanted to have your users table in Airtable and maybe some projects data in Google Sheets and other data like invoices in Zite itself, not yet possible. Right now, an app can only connect to one data source. So be very thoughtful about this. You can, of course, build multiple apps and each app can link to a different data source, but you have to be thoughtful about where your data lives and consolidating the source of that data when you're building. So again, if you're going to build with that Zite backend database, go ahead and build it all here at the data layer so that you have that functionality. Now, the other key takeaway I have for you is that the fields or the columns that are available aren't quite as, let's say, robust as what you might get from a database first tool. You'll notice that I don't have any rollups, for example. When it comes to getting information from this, like I've got a link and where I can link to another table and I can look up information from that table, but I don't have a rollup function where I can't look. Let's say, for example, what's the total spend that I've had with a particular client, right? That would be something where we would want to look at all of the invoices and sum them. I'm also not seeing a formula field type here. So there's no capability of doing calculations in the back end itself, at least not at first glance inside of Zite. So what I'm seeing is a lot of independent fields, which is a field that we write data to, but I'm not seeing a lot of dependent fields aside from the lookup. A dependent field in database building is a field that creates, or rather inherits, its value or its output based on calculations, based on rollups, based on some sort of aggregation function. And we don't see a lot of that here. So there's not a formula, there's not rollups, etc. Now, that doesn't mean that the databases are lackluster, because obviously we can still get pretty amazing functionality. And I'd be willing to bet that your database in Zite is going to mean that you have a faster loading front end application at the end of the day, because the connection is faster for information to pass. So there's a lot of takeaways that you can have from this, but I'm excited to start getting building more and more inside of Zite's databases natively, and really, have that in one place. One closing thought that I have is that I get this question a lot. People always asking if they can build their own solution using no-code tools and then roll out some sort of a SaaS model. They want to white label the solution they built and sell it to their industry. Get this question all the time. And I think that Zite is getting us a little bit closer to that final dream down the road. Now, a couple of things that keep us from being able to do that. Number one, we can't push updates very easily right now. So if you had multiple different clients using a solution, you would have to go in and manually update each one of those whenever you made changes to the underlying logic or architecture. So I think we're getting a little bit closer to that reality when we have tools like this. So you might, or we might, as users of these tools, we might be that much closer to being able to white label the solutions that we've built for ourselves and start selling them to others, which is something I've been waiting for years in the no-code space. And the fact that we're closer to it today makes me pretty darn excited, because I've got a lot of ideas that I'd love to white label and share out there. And I'm sure you do too, especially if you've been watching this channel for any amount of time. So, hey, a lot of cool stuff coming from Zite. Give databases a try and let me know in the comments below what you love about it or what you wish would maybe get improved over time. That's it for this video. I hope you got a ton of value. If you did, make sure to subscribe to the channel and give us a thumbs up here. It will really help the algorithm. But of course, most importantly, keep on building.